Ballinger recommends that we concur in Senate Amendment 1 to House Bill 1228. Mr. Clerk, please read Amendment Number 1.
Amendment Number 1 to House Bill 1228.
Representative Ballinger, you're recognized to explain Amendment 1.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Amendment 1 is real short, but it's real simple. It's one paragraph, and if you've got the paper version, it's on top of page 5. And it essentially makes it real clear that this bill only applies to state after state. It does not apply in a situation where it's a wholly private employer or private employee relationship. This bill to kind of help some people alleviate some concerns. I appreciate your vote.
Members, you've heard an explanation of the amendment. Would anyone like to speak against the amendment? For the amendment? Representative Ballinger, would you like to close for your amendment? You signify that you've done so. Question now before the House is concurrence of Senate Amendment 1 to House Bill 1228. Clerk Machine, Mr. Clerk. Is everyone voted? Casting ballots, Mr. Clerk. With 68 yeas, 19 nays, and 1 present, we have concurred in Senate Amendment 1 to House Bill 1228. Representative Ballinger recommends that we concur in Senate Amendment 2 to House Bill 1228. Please read Amendment Number 2, Mr. Clerk.
Amendment Number 2 to House Bill 1228.
Representative Ballinger, you're recognized to explain the amendment.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Amendment Number 2 is a little more information, but basically what it does is make it real clear what this bill is. That essentially this is a RFRA similar to what we have with the federal RFRA. So you see that the title has changed. It also incorporates the name of the individual who, if they had a RFRA in Kansas, would have possibly survived. Then you come down and look at the legislative finding, just kind of gives a little bit of the history of it. And then if you look on page 5, once again, this language was included and put in here because the governor's office had a little bit of concern about whether the language would provide for the state being held liable, even if the state's not a party to the action. So the only change here is clarification that if the state is not a party to the action, they can't be held liable. And that's all of Amendment 2, and I sure appreciate your vote.
All right, members, for our next question, would anyone like to speak against the amendment? For the amendment? Representative Walker.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have prepared my remarks in opposition to the amendment and to the bill, and I've shared with the members. And with that, I'll be finished. Thank you.
Okay, Representative Ballinger, close the amendment. Has signified that he's closing the amendments of question before the House now. Is the concurrence of Senate Amendment 2 to House Bill 1228. We had a pair on the desk. Representative Mike Neal votes yes. Representative Greg Letting votes no. This was witnessed by Representative Bob Ballinger. Representative Letting is the present member. Are there any procedural objections to this pair? All right, please do not vote either of these two voting machines. Bear the machine, Mr. Clerk. Senate Amendment 2 to House Bill 1228.